Good morning, students. In last video, we have learned about the definitions and of Euler's theorem and homogeneous condition. Okay, you all know what is homogeneous condition. What is homogeneous condition? If f of t x comma t y is equal to t power n of f of x comma y. If a given function is written in this form, if a given function can be written in this form, then the function is said to be homogeneous. That is, if I multiply my variable x with t and y with t, and if it is written as t power n of f of x comma y, that is some t into my function, if I got in this form, then the function is said to be homogeneous. Okay, if the function is homogeneous, I can give the Euler theorem for the given function. So first, see, they have given you a problem here. If u is equal to sine inverse of x plus y by root x plus 2y, show that x dou u by dou x plus y dou u by dou y equal to half tan u. Okay, so this is what we call as what? Euler theorem. This is nothing but Euler's theorem. Okay, so when does the Euler's theorem exist? If the function is homogeneous, Euler theorem will exist. Okay, so first we have to check whether the given function, that is u is equal to sine inverse of x plus y by root x plus root y, is homogeneous or not. So first we have to check that. Then after, we have to go for this condition to solve using Euler's theorem. Okay, so first what we are going to do here is we are going to check the given function is homogeneous or not. But homogeneous, it has to be written in this form. First I am going to consider my function. What is my function here? That is u is equal to sine inverse of x plus y divided by root x plus root y. See, as I said earlier, the trigonometry, this is an inverse trigonometric function. Here, if I give xt for x, yt for y, I cannot take my t to the what? In front like this. I cannot bring my t out of the function. Okay? So, in such case, we cannot say the function is homogeneous. So, here, u is not homogeneous. Okay? U is not homogeneous function. Homogeneous function. So, unless it is going to be a homogeneous function, we cannot what? Say the Euler theorem will exist. So, first we have to make this function to be a homogeneous function. Then only we can say Euler theorem can exist. After giving that, we can do this condition. So first we are going to make this given function into a homogeneous function. For that, what I am going to do is, I am just going to multiply by sine on both sides. So by multiplying by sine, I will be getting what? Sine u is equal to here sine and sine inverse will get cancelled. So this will be only x plus y divided by root x plus root y equal to, I am going to assign a new name for this function, let it be f. Okay, that is, we are giving this name f. Okay, so here, see, this is an inverse trigonometric function. We cannot bring the t from the function. Okay, so we are making this to an multiplying by sine throughout the function. So I got sine u is equal to x plus y by root x plus 2y. Now I have named it as f. What we are going to do next is, I am just going to see here sine u is equal to this. This is equal to f. So we can say whether sine u is equal to f, f is equal to this. Whatever, we can consider whatever way we need. Okay. Now I am going to consider what? Consider f is equal to, here I have in x and y, so I can write this as f of x comma y is equal to x plus y divided by root x plus root y. Okay, by using this function I am going to check the homogeneous condition. So now what I am going to do is, I am going to multiply my x and y with t, that is tx comma ty is equal to tx plus ty divided by root of tx plus root of ty. Now here I can take a t in common, I will be getting x plus y divided by, here I can take root t in common, so I will be getting root x plus root y. So you can cancel this and you will be getting root t here. So that can be written as equal to t power half of. See what is this? This is my f of x comma y. So I can write this as what? F of x comma y. We call this as a condition for homogeneous, isn't it? So this is my homogeneous condition. So this function f is said to be a homogeneous function here. So I can conclude what? F is a homogeneous function. F is a homogeneous function of degree. What is my degree? The power which I have for the constant is called degree, okay? Of degree 1 by 2 in the variable what? X and Y. So, my function is a homogeneous function here. So, the given function is homogeneous, so I can what? I can prove the Euler's theorem, okay? So, now the Euler theorem. By Euler's theorem, what is the Euler theorem? That is x dou u by dou x plus y dou u by dou y equal to n into c. Here I have taken u as a function. I will be giving u as a function. But what I said here, my f is a homogeneous function. Even they have given you u as a function, I have considered f as a function. So I have to define my Euler theorem for the function which is homogeneous here. Okay? So my function, I have defined my function as f, so I am making use of f here. Okay, you should not make use of u. My what I said is f is a homogeneous function, so I have to make use of f on it. Okay? So x into dou f by dou x, y into dou f by dou y, and here I will be getting n into f. Okay? So here what I am going to do is, what is my n? N is nothing but degree of the homogeneous function. What is my degree? Half. So n is nothing but 1 by 2. I am going to consider f as sine u, because what I have said earlier, this f is nothing but both sine u and this algebraic function. Okay? So I have used this for homogeneous condition. To solve the given condition, I am going to use this function sine u. So here I am going to consider my f as sine u. Okay? So now I am going to substitute f as sine u in my Euler theorem. So x into dou of sine u divided by dou x plus y into dou of sine u divided by dou y is equal to half into sine u. Now we are going to differentiate this to bring what? We have to make this as x dou u by dou x plus y dou u by dou y, but I have sine u there. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to differentiate this, okay? Partially with respect to x here and partially with respect to y here. And you all know u is a function of what? X and y. So I can differentiate u in terms of x and also in terms of y. See, I guess I have sine u here. So if I differentiate sine u, I will be getting cos u. And again, I have to differentiate u because u is also a function. Okay? Even sine u is a function and u separately is a function in x and y. So first I am going to, that is I am going to use chain rule here. Okay? So first I am going to differentiate sine u. While differentiating sine, I will be getting cos u. Okay? And while differentiating u with respect to x, it is general function. That is I have u of x comma y, I am going to differentiate u. While differentiating u, I have to write that what? Dou u by dou x. Okay? So similarly here, while differentiating sine u, I will be getting cos u. Well, while differentiating u, I will be getting what? Dou u by dou y. See? I have differentiated sine u with respect to x. While differentiating sine, I got cos. Again, with respect to x, I am differentiating y partially with respect to x. I will be getting dou u by dou x. And here also the same. And here I have half into sine u. Now I am going to take cos in common. So cos u into x dou u by dou x plus y dou u by dou y equal to half into sine u. Half into sine u. Now take the cos to that side. So we will be getting what? X into dou u by dou x plus y into dou u by dou y equal to half into sine by cos is nothing but tan u. This is what we have to consider my given function. While checking this, this is not a homogeneous function because you cannot bring the constant away from the from the function. So I'm saying this is not a homogeneous function. Next, to make this as a homogeneous function, I'm just multiplying by sine on both sides. So I'll be getting sine u is equal to x plus y by root x plus root by root is equal to u. Okay, I have made it as f. Now I'm going to consider only this for making it to be a homogeneous function. So I'm taking, I'm giving x as tx, y as ty. I have made use of x, this type, that is f of x, tx comma ty. I have replaced x and y as tx and ty. On solving, I got what? T power half of x plus y by root x plus root y, and it is nothing but my f of x comma y. And from this, I can say the given function is a homogeneous function of degree half. And that is what we have given here. Since I have considered this function as f, I have given f is a homogeneous function of degree 1 by 2 in x and y. So since the given function is homogeneous, we can say Euler theorem will exist. Okay? So by Euler theorem, this is my Euler theorem. And here, see, I have said f is a homogeneous function. That's why I have given my Euler theorem in terms of f. And here, I am going to consider, see, my m is half. And f is sine u, I have given you earlier, and we have made use of that. And while differentiating, I got x into dou u by dou x plus y into dou u by dou y equal to half into